Every Pacific person has a story to tell, how their families came here and what's happened since. In our last story, we meet the Ness family, father Tingi Lau and daughter Miriam. Tingi is a well-known political activist and well-respected musician. Miriam is a first-time mum to daughter Phoenix. Tingi Lau was born in New Zealand in the 1950s, the youngest of three children. His father came over for work and his mother followed later.
He bought a house in Karaka Street, Newton, just down the road from the King's Arms Tavern. Yeah. So, you know, we were always close to alcohol. And, the first Pacific Islanders to come over gathered at those kind of places. They were hard-working men and hard-drinking as well. And I think the culture back then was that the man dominated. So I grew up seeing a lot of the violent family things that went on. Men chasing their wives up the street with, you know, I kill you stuff, yeah?
If that wasn't enough, tragedy struck the family when Tingi was just 6 years old.
My dad died in my arms when I was six. So I know about death, you know, and I know that life is short and you got to do as much as you can.
His mother was left to bring up three children on her own.
It must have been really hard for her. The same, I would say, as any solo parent. She raised me and my sisters by herself to live together in peace and harmony. Nonofu whakawhiheleaki.
Tingi has spent all of his life living in central Auckland. Growing up in the 60s and 70s, he saw a lot of injustices. So when the Polynesian Panthers formed, it was like a moth to a flame.
Being just as violent or even more to the people that they feel are particularly violent will certainly make the public, or the members of the Polynesian public that are being arrested in that, will make them feel more aggressive towards any sort of police.
The Polynesian Panthers, I think, was when I started getting politicised. I learnt that the host of this country didn't really know what we were about either. All they saw was work, labour, and it was like slavery type thing. And to do it and to say nothing, right? And they could do anything like low-cost housing, racist laws, landlords, the whole thing, immigration, the whole thing, all that. Well, I learned that, see? Yeah. And I'm thinking, no, that's not right. And I refer back to the Bible, yeah, relieve the oppressed. Okay. And I live it. Yeah, yeah.
I didn't feel like I needed to go out there and follow in Dad's footsteps and start chaining myself to fences and things like that. I didn't have that kind of feeling, but I knew in here, in my mind, that it was important.
And the activism didn't stop there. He became politically involved with Māori land issues in 1975 and Bastion Point protests as well, and the Springbok tour in 1981, spending 9 months in prison for his beliefs. Being an activist also helped him with his love of music and his religion, Rastafari, which came after Bob Marley's one and only visit in 1979.
Good evening. Yes, you know. Come a long way.
You know, call it spiritual music, you know, to get more revolutionized, you know.
I just related to that straight away. It sounded Polynesian to me, sounded Ireland, the rhythm, the strum, and then the words, the biblical teaching, straight away. That's me, yeah. So 79, after Bob left here, I formed a band called Unity, and later on, like 2000, I put the Pacific onto it.
God defend New Zealand and all humanity for helping my people in the South Pacific. If
I take it back to my mum, her teachings from the Bible and stuff, and then along comes Bob Marley, umpteen years later, and the Bible it is. But he's talking like, you know, black man redemption. right? Whereas with Mum's teaching and from the Bible, it was like Jesus Christ and God is white, right? Because that's the way she would have received it back then. Along comes Bob going, Rastafari, Christ and his kingly character. Then I think, oh, Mum was right, Bob was right, the Bible's right there.
It's reggae's like blood in my veins because of Dad. Mom and Dad.
Yeah.
Upbringing.
Miriam's enjoying motherhood. She sung with Tingy, but unlike her dad and brother Shay Fu, singing is not really her thing.
I don't really want to get into the music industry. Surprisingly, it shocks everyone. But your dad and but your brother and I just don't want to go there. Yeah, I'm happy to be a part of the crowd. Buy my ticket like everyone else.
Oh, you have to buy your ticket?
I don't have to, but it's still supporting New Zealand music and it's supporting my brother and my dad and their bros. And
no, I'd never thought I'd see the day when you would.
But both dad and daughter are extremely proud of what family member Shay has achieved in music. A family collaboration is on the wish list.
Well, that's always in the cards too. I hope so. When we're a family type thing, yeah, we did one Waitangi thing together, eh?
Yep.
And it was gospel. So, you know, like around that, Blessed Be the Ties, eh? That was the song, eh?
Yep.
Yeah.
Tingy has three children. Miriam is the youngest. The kids have Māori ancestry. And for Miriam, learning Niuean is a dream.
But it's still one of my wishes.
Mm.
Same with Māori too. Love to be able to speak Māori as well.
Mm. I want to speak Māori too.
Yeah. Dad actually wants to.
Oh yeah, yeah. But for I know Māori's Niue and Māori as well, and that we communicate in English, not a problem.
Yeah.
I know our heart is Niue Māori.
So being a speaker or not doesn't make you a Niue or a Māori because I can't speak it.
I am a Niue first and foremost and a Rasta man and a father and a grandfather.
Miriam and Tingy Lau Ness share a love for Rasta, music and family and a deep respect for each other.
Dad's like my little, like another version of, like a Niue Bob Marley to me. Niue Bob Marley, how's that?
Yeah, I'm free to do what I want to do now.
Yeah.
You won't ask me for anything now, Charlotte.
No, but don't wait up.
No. I'm really proud of Mother for, you know, being where she is and what she's done. And she just did it, because that was her life.
There are other people like me, we just don't know about them. And we will find out where they are.
Bless you, thank you.